Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video with the Artist Moth. Today we're going to be doing a star system for somebody called Flame, killing it too. He's asked for a sun-like star with 6 rocky planets with elliptic orbits, 5 gas giants, and make sure all the gas giants have moons and asteroids.
Okay, so first we're going to start on with a sun-like star. So, let's get this, Alright, if I just put the sun in. I should get a sun-like star in a minute. Come on. I guess that's close enough. Put that there. Ooh, hang on a second. Stop. Alright, then that's increasing the size. To just under sun mass. Change that to only 400. 400 million years old. Okay. Habitable zone. So we want 6 rocket planets.
And I want you to make one planet orange or some black.
Orange with some black. So what we're gonna do. So what's the axis of the star?
Rotation.
Let's make that 4.7. And then let's go to composition. And does it feel lines? Turn that up slightly. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna speed up its rotation too. Maybe 17 hours? I feel like that needs to be... Okay. Let's take the first rocky planet. Let's pull it on. Sort of an orbit. Fairly large iron core. We're going to make this one. Let's have a look. Why don't we make this one? Pretty. It's kind of a pretty high albedo. I don't have any water. going to put through. The Prelor is going to have a magnetic field, say 2 radii. Rotation 23 hours. This has, I didn't even mess with the rotation. It's a rotation speed of 23 hours. What's the temperature? 391. Already has clouds, that's pretty cool. I like that a lot. But it needs to be an elliptical orbit, so I'm going to increase it. Increase its orbit slightly, speed up time slightly, add the next rocky planet in. Orange with some brown. Orange. Brown. Okay. This too easy. Orange. Or some brown. So that's 2 Venus-like worlds. So we're going to call this star F1 AM 3 gonna add this one. Orbital period, just turn it down slightly. Let's see. Turn it up. This is 1.03, that's all. So they're pretty large planets when you think about it. So it's going to have a slightly thicker atmosphere than Earth. And albedo is going to be pretty high. 0.86. Give this a 'pretty strong magnetic field. So, should we give this one a moon? Can we reverse the speed? We can. Okay, so that's got a moon. This one's going to have pretty dark foliage with nice yellow beaches. Or should we have it? That's 3. So then we add in another planet. These planets are all basically following the path of wait, how big is this planet? 2 times. 2 times. Really large iron core. Field is turned up. Super field. Rotation period. I guess it's not down. What's the atmosphere going to be? Not a moon. I can decrease it. again. Dark green for the just gonna have okay, so that one's been torn to pieces. And I could possibly put a giant moon here. Is this one on Luke's orbit? No, it doesn't look like it. That's okay, because it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's put this fifth planet. On a rather wild orbit. It could possibly be a captured planet. So it's probably going to be the largest out of them. So this planet is frozen. On the outer edges, but then it heats up as it comes closer into the sun. And it should start to freeze. Second now. There you go. It's just frozen. The clouds are disappearing. And now it's a frozen icefall. Motion, tidally locked, it's going to slow its rotation. If we go on the surface of this planet, look at where the sun is. That would be scary, plummeting in towards the system. But it is a cool sight, seeing the planets orbit the sun. Looks like possibly not going to. Oh, the planet's heating up. The planet's got water. Ice has melted. And we're sipping past the sun right now. That's a really cool sight. I like that. And now we're slipping back out. And the planet will soon become an iceberg once again. I feel like, give it a magnetic field. Ten times of Gauss. Don't want to turn this on. Yeah, I've turned it off because yeah, I don't know. So that the planet does indeed have an axis. And when we are then going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's 5 planets. We're gonna then add a 6th rocky planet, but we are going to add like a sort of like a dead zone. So where do the orbit planets orbit? Orbit like that. We go here and add the dead zone about like that. Okay. Iron core doesn't need to be that big. Give it some ice. Like that. Albedo, probably not too high. Like that. Okay. Well, maybe make it 9 atmospheres? Probably not. Maybe 1 atmosphere. Does that still keep it warm? No way that keeps it warm. Okay. So just like the 3rd planet from the sun, this one's gonna have a pretty high elliptical orbit. Probably not too high. Probably around there. There you go. Okay. So let's have a look. Let's decrease that to that. 21.3 degrees. And let's give it a magnetic field. 101 Gauss. No thank you. 10 Gauss can do. That's a pretty strong magnetic field. This one is, how big is this planet? Let's turn it up slightly. Like 6 Earths. I feel like probably making that smaller. There you go. Maybe 4 Earths. 4 Earths will do. Let's go to the planet. Let's put asteroid moving around it, and another one. And another one fairly close. Okay, there you go. And then we're going to give it a giant move. Ooh, that's a big move. Got a lot of ice. Okay. Put the albedo up to like 90. 94. I think that's a good idea. 94. Right. Now, let's focus on the star. And then we're gonna.
So he says 5 gas giants. Make sure all the gas giants have moons and asteroids. And I want 4 dwarf planets with bizarre orbits.
Okay, so let's get a random gas giant. Or can we get? If we get Saturn. And put Saturn on this. Orbit like this. So the gas giants aren't going to be on elliptical orbits, they're going to be on nice stable orbits. Give it the iron, give it the water. We're going to make this gas giant pretty big. We're going to call it, let's call it this is gonna have one, two, turn orbits on. So that's the first gas giant. Then we're gonna take the second one. I think this planet's all in a nice cube. Yeah, it is. Minus 21 degrees. This one is minus 35. But it's on a higher elliptical orbit. We're gonna put the next gas giant. So we're gonna take. If we zoom in here. Oh, that's a really nice gas giant. So, if we. Expand the orbit of this. And auto orbit. Orbit. We're going to then go all possible elements, incline. I want that higher. All that has a higher incline. We put as 3. Yeah, 3 seems good. Get rid of edit. Go to here. This gas giant looks super nice. So it's going to be a fairly large gas giant. Get rid of iron. Make the silica core pretty small. It's 116,000 kilometers wide. That's really nice. Rotational period, turn that down to 12 hours. Okay. Then we're going to take some moons. Put one in orbit there, another in orbit there, another in orbit there. put it in orbit around there. And put that one in orbit around there. And then some asteroid moons. So one there, and one there. That's really nice. Okay, so that's one. No, that's two gas giants. How many gas giants? Five. Right. I don't know, that looks alright, but... I like that a lot. Incline. This one's going to have just a few large moons. So one, two, three. So only like three super big moons. Four. Okay. Six, right. Down, a lot of ices. A lot of ices. A lot of ices. And then maybe a few asteroid moons. There you go. That's three gas giants, and then the fourth one, put that here. I like that, not that a lot actually. So let's make this one. It's a very nice size actually. Get rid of the iron. Get rid of this. Could be a ice giant actually. So it could be a fairly light ice giant. So maybe it could be like half the size. So only about 77 Earths in mass. And it could have like maybe 2 giant moons. And then a few. Smaller moons in orbit. And then we're going to take another gas giant. So the last gas giant. The last one. So this one's going to be way out. It's going to be way out here. So it's really far away. It's super far away. If you look how far away that is, the sun looks like another star. That's how far away it really is. And this one's gonna be slightly more advanced. How big is it in radius? 42,892. 42,892. 46,000. 42,000. Okay. So this one, I'm going to need to have 'Cause you're tilt. So this is gonna be like a GI move. It's gonna be like a super move. This one's gonna be yellow, pink, probably not that color. Tidally locked. So it doesn't reflect any light at all. But this one's gonna have the most asteroid moons. They're gonna reach all the way out here. It may even have some dwarf planet moons as well. So this basically has a humongous collection of moons. Even has one that's, you know, all the way out here. Don't even know how far away that really is. But it's a long way. Lobo saying what? He wants four dwarf planets in wacky orbits. So I can put one like that, another like that, another like this, and another one like that. And then a red dwarf star orbiting 1 light year away. This one has 7 planets around it. smuffling toy. We're gonna put the closest planet. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay. I guess we could put a gas giant in play here. Gestational period. Let's give it single moon. Okay. So this is the
flame
killinity. Killinity 2 system. A lot of planets. 2 main stars. 1 sun-like and 1 teeny tiny tiny red dwarf. So let's put it on a chart. Oh wow. A lot of rocky planets. The sun is huge, and you've got this teeny weeny red dwarf. That is pretty cool, actually. So, thank you guys for watching the video. If you did enjoy this video, give it a thumbs up. If you did not enjoy this video, give it a thumbs down. Put in the comment section what system you want me to make next. Do you have a system idea? If you do, put it in the comment section below and I'll try and make it. Bye bye.